come to motorsports events, there's electricity, there's that sound.
For us, it's kind of like a dream day. We're here at Le Mans. We're here with our motorcycle company, with the people that we've met. We're talking about passion.
For them to make the time to meet and talk with us seems like really special.
Go, go, go!
Bruno is fantastic. He just knows so much. He's witnessed so much. I mean, we walked in that room and you're hearing him go, and he's like a conductor orchestrating the story.
This is like a really long stint, right? You start at like 11 o'clock in the morning.
For this event, I woke up at 5:30 to say good morning Le Mans at 7 o'clock exactly. Every year, I want to say good morning Le Mans at 7 o'clock.
And you have so much energy, so how do you prepare for that physically?
In fact, I'm going to fall. Boom.
Yeah.
Tuesday. But 2 days after.
And sleep for a week?
Yes. 3 weeks to recover. Yeah. 3 weeks.
Do you think that there's a crucial time in the 24 hours where things change, or is it different all the time?
Especially in between, I don't know why, but 10 o'clock and 1 o'clock on Sunday, because you've got some rest of, you know, of rubbers on the track, some gravel sometimes, and because many people or many drivers begin to be tired, sometimes up, they have a spin, they lose control. So there is a period, 3 hours.
10 to 1, go. The twilight, the new day, something.
Something could go really wrong, or something could go really right. I feel really fortunate to be able to come and have this experience. And I don't know, like Frederick, what an amazing story that is.
I started with the question of, like, what brought you here? And he went to the dream, you know, to be in Le Mans and to drive. How many races have you done?
La première fois que j'ai roulé dans une voiture de course, c'était février 2015.
So you had no racing experience even as an amateur before your accident. But a dream.
Yeah, a dream. Les 24 heures du Mans, c'est la plus belle course, la plus difficile course au monde. C'est tellement, c'est magnifique, c'est mythique. Il faut peut-être essayer de la faire.
Say yes.
Yeah.
Say yes.
Yeah. And then to get to sit with him and go through the practical things, of just seeing, you know, how he drives with the right arm and how he uses the brake.
Donc ça c'est le volant. Mm.
That's your steering wheel.
Yes. Yeah.
So you have also the disadvantage of you only get to use one arm.
Eh oui.
It was really extraordinary to see this individual affecting so many people. It's amazing.
As I get older and I meet racers, I like always connect with them right away.
You know, when we were talking with Tom, and I was just like, I looked over at you and you were like, yeah.
Well, I mean, immediately you notice this intensity that you would expect with any driver that has achieved what he's achieved, right? But
yeah.
Something in his eyes and his intensity and...
Comes off his body, too.
Yeah, right?
Who taught you how to drive?
I was very impressed by my dad, obviously. So many times, even in winter, he would like to drive me to school in the snow, driving very obviously sideways and love that. And I couldn't see out from the passenger seat and drop me off at school. I remember things like that. But
you didn't become a rally car driver.
I love endurance racing. I love this race.
For me, I love that moment where I was like, so have you come up with a philosophy? He just goes, be on it.
It's teamwork and the team spirit and being open and being honest and then at the same time be on it when you're in it. This combination is definitely what you need to be on it.
I don't know, for me it's like that moment when you say to be on it, you know, that thing where you have to, you do all this time to prepare.
Yeah.
And then someone gives you the opportunity, right? You get in the car and the guy and you're waiting, and they go, you gotta like, and that's for me. I have that with action. I don't have near death, but sometimes you feel like when I acted.
Yeah,
with,
it depends which movie, huh? If we then, yeah.
When I worked with Al Pacino, you know, for me he was like a god to me. He is. He's so amazing.
But you need that inspirement to bring the passion.
Yeah, you'd be alive, right? You want to be alive. I think that idea of being here to learn and to share.
Definitely a genuine connection.
Yeah.